putting out projects. I sold fire. Choose your own price is what I told buyers. I keep a small circle, that's a dope size. Making money behind the scenes with Ghost Rider. My label frontin' it, then recoup what's sold. I push releases back when it's moving slow. Studio and hit my ceiling, I got room to grow. But these branches hit the ceiling in the room I grow. 16 bars, if you need a verse. 16 ounces, cheap as dirt. Delivery hard, a song is 3 P's.
They call me Ronnie Bay the Prince, but out in Cali, I'm the king.
I lost mad stacks, but they can have that.
Ice, nigga!
Cash back, yeah, that's ass cap. Ups and downs, I don't mind the business. Vices listen, tell them mind your business.
Too much daylight in your face, white boy. Sun blocking won't protect you.
About to buy a field, about to grow commercial. I'm on tour with 100 pack out of town. When I say I'm about to go commercial, that's 1,000 pounds. I'm about to go commercial. Nah.
Live from King of the Dot, Calgary. We all drunk as fuck. Make some noise! Fucking lit we are right now. Shouts out to the homie Frenzy right here for putting this shit on.
Frenzy, baby.
Bang, bang, karma gang. This is Frenzy, baby. Motherfucker, say something record.
Say something, baby. What?
Up, baby?
I got my homie right here, man.
It's prehistoric 613 papapri.com. Let's go.
What's up, man? What's your name, bro?
D-Dub. Hit up KOTDstore.com. Yeah. Cop all the new merch. We shipping worldwide now. King of the Dot.
Dub in the house.
Yeah. All right, I want you guys to pay attention because this battle is really fucking special for me. This shit is real shit. This is bringing back the fun in battling. This, to me, is the real shit. This is not... shit, this is where he's at. So I'm gonna let these guys introduce themselves. On my left,
Kid
Fucking Twist!
Yeah! Money Gang, Gentlemen's Club.
Oh yeah! And on my motherfucking right!
He did the coin toss. Cheddar won the coin toss. Chose Kid Twist to go first. When he's ready, it's 90 seconds on him. Calgary, be respectful. This is going to be hella fun. Let's go.
Yo. You ready?
Yeah.
This is the battle you wanted your whole life. Like you were destined for me. This is the battle I took so Sketch would stop fucking messaging me. You've got a weird obsession with me. I'm not worried I'll lose to this dude. I'm worried my stalker's trying to turn me into a skin suit. He's got a lens with a long zoom and a dark room with all the pictures he takes of me. He makes YouTube accounts just to hate on me, then his other accounts reply, praising me. And if you go into his basement down his hidden stairwell, you'll see the Kid Twist statue he built out of my old bottles of hair gel. That's fucked up. But on some real shit, the Blue Jays owe me stacks. The dude with flips in the six, I was known as that way before Joey Bats. So quit the phony act. Don't pretend that we rap the same. The only time you see cheese come off the head is the end of a Packers game. Yo. Your real name is Shay Roger? I thought it was Gay Fokker. And how's your rap name Cheddar when you've never aged proper? You've got the face of a preteen and physique of a decayed walker, so any girl who dates you is both a cradle and grave robber. I'm saying you're an awkward-looking dork. And that's what every song you wrote's about, too, so what are we battling for if we're both making jokes about you? Even as a parody artist, you're hard to take serious. If Weird Al was here now, he'd be on some Ghostface shit. He gave you a grace period. But that's not fair. Because Weird Al is nicer when he flows on rapper's music. You took your whole style from Amish paradise but can't hold a candle to it. You're a copy of a copy. So the fact you have a rep seems wrong. You even bit your slogan from the fucking Chia Pet theme song. Ch-ch-ch-chia, fuck out of here. And since since you took your battle rubric off me, ask Shuffle how it went when pupils fought me. It's YTV in the 90s the way I show you student bodies. Because I'll always be the best joker. It's like when Heath Ledger moved on. They only let Jared Leto play the part because I slept for too long. Let's go.
Alright, you guys can hear me a little bit?
Right.
First of all, you're 29 and you call yourself a kid. Enough with the babble. Time to trade Nickelodeon for Discovery Channel. Somebody should take legal action on you like a judge with a gavel to take the kid out of your name like a custody battle. And all you underground nerds can get laid out like a futon, son. I'll body snack the Ripper and Mad Child in a 2-on-1. Think you're better with the words, I'll even beat you on the Scrabble board. Show up at your mansion and I'll push you off your paddle board. Looking more hipster than the people that you battle for. Hipster like Macklemore working at the Apple Store. On top of that, you're the girliest opponent that I've had before. Girly like Mandy Moore working at the candy store. A copycat with a big ass beak, it isn't hard to see. That means I wrote To Kill a Mockingbird like Harper Lee. But you've been writing a book for 10 years, suffering from writer's block. Laughed when I saw this comic stripped of his title shot. Now King of the Dot won't bookmarks like Kid Twist getting paid to rap. Got no spine, that's why they want their paper back. But your career as a battler and an author are morbidly alike. It speaks volumes that you've got so many issues when performing on the mic. But it's too late to turn the page on all that corny shit you write, cause this is the final chapter in the story of your life.
You're the biggest nerd we've seen this far. You say I work at the Apple Store, yeah, because every line's a genius bar. This shit is so white, I guarantee there'll be no fight. And they'll post it to World Star titled When Keeping It Real Goes Right. But you named yourself Chetta instead of Cheddar. Because you think it sounds urban and hard. Fuck off. We know damn well you say that word with an R. But hey, look, we all go through that awkward looking for acceptance stage. You remind me of myself in 7th grade. Except you're 28. So if you and T-Rex battled, man, that shit would be a tense one. Because grown man bars, that's something you're exempt from. And with that squeaky-ass voice, no girl's taking you home with her. You're Doc Ellis. From that high pitch, your game is a no-hitter. But I'm honestly surprised that your name didn't grow bigger. I mean, we heard you on all those early beats from Kanye. You're a dope singer. Your facial skin is full of deep pits and grease slicks. You're like a snack addict, always popping cheese zits. You rep Alberta so hard, your whole face is an oil patch. So now that Notley took over, you gotta move to avoid the tax. This is what you wanted. But the ending to his daydream is grim. She's crushed in a bag. I'm making KD with him. You introduce yourself as Marshall to the ladies and grin, but even when they think you're Eminem, the chance they want the shade D is slim. Yo, the chance they want the shade D is slim. His fans are like, yo, check out the flows he drops, they're advanced. What, because he just got very ant that did the night at the Roxbury dance? Like, yo, hickory dickory dock. If you spit with this rhythm, then stop. The doctors need some new drugs when they're treating you, because your shit sounds like Bone Thugs with leukemia. They say that I'm a comic, not a rapper. Well, if that hype's true, I would rather not rap than fucking rap like you. Because flow is nothing if you can't write too, so I'll never think you're tight. Because I could count your quotables on one hand if that hand was fingers right.
How do you constantly constantly complain about the politics in battles and then literally bring a politician to your battle? How do you pull the biggest gimmick of the year and still get bodied every round? You embarrass Norm Kelly and you let your city down. You're a disgrace. Could have done it in a way that had some taste instead of, here's Norm Kelly, you can say it to his face. Man, that's like winning a million and dropping it at the dollar store. Like casting a supervillain and ending up with Pauly Shore. That's like having a crystal ball and just before it shows you the future and what it's got in store, you drop it on the marble floor. In terms that you can follow more, that's like coming to battle with a holographic Charizard and laying down a Bulbasaur. And yeah, Norm Kelly dissed me last night. It was comical, actually. But then she told me to tell you and your family to tell Norm that he's no longer welcome in Calgary. Man, you know I got that hometown advantage, no matter the scenario. I'm Kanye in Chicago, Don Cherry in Ontario. Got all of Canada with me. Feel like the man in my city. Feel like the Pope when he's walking through Vatican City. Swagged out chilling in the Sistine Chapel while you hanging out at home watching 16 Candles. But you know where Twist is in his element? Twisted Element. That's the gay bar. That's the gay bar in Calgary. When the kids near, shit gets weird. This here won't cut it. Got fleas all in that little beard and grease all in that mullet. Take the shit, I can't stop it. Whole career about to plummet. When I rap like I'm rapping on beat, you pretend that you hate it, but I know you love it.
Look, man, all that rhythm shit you do is too extra. You just make it look like rhyming is hard. You brought up Pokemon holographs because that's the only time you had shine on a card. Yeah. And then, yo, this is where it gets real. I'm sorry I gotta do this. But it's about time his personal life really got exposed. So I was gonna dig up dirt. But sometimes it's just better not to know. What? You thought I was gonna drop some heavy personals? That's not our lane, and I don't need caustic shit to beat you. I am not Arcane! You've got all my qualities they don't like, but at exaggerated heights, it's like a YouTube comment about me came to life. Cause I'm Pharrell, Corey's Chad, you're the other guy that hung about. You know, the one in the nerd crew nobody gives a fuck about. Look, that was a bit harsh. I'm just trying to put him back in his place, cause getting compared to Sharon, that's a slap in the face. If K-Shine had smacked you, your head would have damn near been severed from your neck, cause all it would take is that flick of the wrist that Cheddar to connect. Imagine he played his own shit at the strip club. Now that's fucked up to picture. You're watching a girl twerk to Cheddar singing about his allergies to dust as you tip her. And you date co-workers, so you feel tease pain being in love with a stripper because there is not a surface in your house that isn't covered in glitter. If you thought C was fire, it must have been your team logo. I'm here to keep these nerds in line like a chess team photo. So now I got him in a panic. You should pop another Xanax. I'll show Jay Baruchel how this shit works. That's Popular Mechanics. Was your big shot when you saw our names up on the poster, but you don't want this spotlight. It's frostbite. You'll lose face from the exposure. And you brought up Pauly Shore, but remember that scene in the Goofy movie? Well, that's how I can leave you, because these punches got Cheddar leaning. Tower of Jesus! I'm a missionary. I'm invading his turf just to take him to church. I know you all hate my city too, so that's just making it worse. But it's like Alberta and Ontario had our locations reversed. Cause you paid me for heat and I gave him this work. Yeah.
It's on Cheddar. Let's go.
You wanna do, yo, listen, man. You wanna do some Pokemon rebuttals? I'll be catching them all. Like how my rap won't stop till competitors fall. But you have never gotten better at all. Like Pikachu in the original series, I guess you'll never evolve. And I'd much rather be the DJ at the strip club making some of the wealth than the creepy virgin who gets kicked out for touching himself. Mega rounds are way longer than 90 seconds. Guess battle rap is always on your mind. I'm glad you were so inspired to think about me for such a long amount of time. I've been strategically writing for every possible scenario that might unfold. I'm still just trying to figure out if that dress was blue and black or white and gold. Yes! Yes! My style is brand new. My style is brand new, ready to blow like it's carbonated. Your style is old, washed up, boring, and carbon dated. Contemplated on some complicated schemes and concentrated. Stayed calm, accommodated my thoughts as they congregated. Then it came to me. You and I are nothing alike. I was trying to make comparisons, but ended up with nothing to write. So don't compare us to each other on some white guy shit just because you drive like this and high five like this. Battles to music, Alex Larson doesn't fit. I'm Alan Parsons on the mix, Max Martin with the hits. I kill it in ways that Al Larson couldn't wish. Got me raising my voice like Al Sharpton in this bitch. Oh, yeah. Take skinny, nerdy white guys like me, 360 and Roan, and then compare them to people like Kid Twist and Sharone. It's not the same. Two completely different types of rappers, and if you can't tell the difference, your opinion doesn't matter. I'm sorry. Always acting like some sort of proud father. Think you're everybody's idol because you've been around longer. But I remember when I had no rhythm, when I never had a clue. Then I stepped my game up while you did nothing to improve. So you can try to claim that I've been looking up to you, but I surpassed your level years ago. Who's looking up to who?
Like a motherfucking rock star.
Go, go, go. She keep it hot to death.
Like a bottle of sriracha.
Go, go. She smoking, she smoking.